Jaipur State, unquestionably the most colorful of all the cities in India. It was founded in 1728 by the mathematician and astronomer Jai Singh, who aspired to make it the most wonderful city in India, and succeeded at least in making it the most unique. This main street is over 100 feet in width and about 2 miles in length, running in a straight line. In addition to being purely oriental in its atmosphere, Jaipur is one of the cleanest and most prosperous cities in India. The buildings are all painted in one uniform color, a rose pink, which reflects a soft and fascinating light. The shops run along both sides of the street, each being a single cell in a continuous arcade. The roofs seem to provide a habitation for goats, and more particularly for monkeys, who skip about from window to window, helping themselves to anything and everything that suits their fancy. Perhaps there is no place in the world where birds and beasts live in closer proximity with mankind than they do here in Jaipur. The reason for this may be due to the fact that the Jain religion, a more orthodox branch of Hinduism which thrives here, prohibits the injuring or killing of anything that lives in flesh. The adherents of this religion, numbering about 1 million of India's population, would not so much as lift a finger to brush a fly or an insect from their baby's eyes. Moreover, the Jains actually support beast hospitals where old or lame animals are housed and fed. These little tick birds, however, are not so religious, for their diet consists of the ticks and insects which inhabit the skins of dumb beasts. It is remarkable to note how little fear the animals and birds seem to have of each other, or of the human life that moves about them. Aside from the extremes of religious fanaticism, this kindness to dumb animals seems to reflect itself upon the people of Jaipur, for they are of a contented and peaceful nature, living in a sort of bovine resignation to life as it chooses to deal with them and all that lives around them. No one has been able to prove just where the proverbial Ark of Noah anchored with its cargo of animals, but if we may be permitted to venture our guess, we would say Jaipur. For nowhere else in the world have we seen so many different types of animals mingling so freely with mankind. This leopard has a little growl for us, but for his master, he has all the gentleness of a kitten. On the road to Amber, the former capital of Jaipur, we are reminded of the facetious remark, "When better bullock carts are built, India will build them." And now we arrive at the deserted city of Amber, where we will go for a ride on the Maharaja's elephant.